my beautiful Pisces friends, and welcome to your horoscope for December of 2020, where this is our last monthly horoscope together of 2020. So a little bittersweet, but it's also very cool because maybe you've traveled with me all year and allowed me to travel with you, and we're coming to the end of a chapter, the end of a little time together. And even if this is your first visit here, thank you so much for letting me be a part of that and being a part of it with me as well. This is a busy month. We are shifting energies. We've got two major planets switching signs. We've got an eclipse happening. Mercury is going to be out of bounds. This is a busy, busy month, not to mention that the energy is moving forward because majority of the planets are moving forward. So lots going on this month. I don't want to hold you up with too much housekeeping because I'd love to get you in here. But please keep in mind, Pisces, that the eat and greets will continue to soldier on over here. We've got Patricia Walsh, Kira Sutherland, Linda Bird, Victor Oliver's coming to talk about Dragonic astrology. Peter Burns is coming to talk about astrology and palm reading, which I think is so cool. Michael Bartlett will be here talking about your maverick planets. We'll also have Rose Marcus here. If the words can come out of my mouth, you can tell this is a Mercury retrograde when I'm recording. And we will also have Sally Ducharme here. So either way, I love to see you in the Eat and Reads. I love when you show up. I love your comments down below, and I look forward to seeing there. And remember that you can always join me on Patreon to watch them absolutely ad-free. And the Patreon will be expanding for exclusive Patreon content over there as well. So however you connect with the Eat and Greets, I just love to see your connection. All right, Pisces, let's get in here and talk about what's going on. So first thing to note, as we're coming into December and we're working our way through here, your 10th house, the house of career, the house of your reputation. So if you're done working, you're retired, whatever it is, this is also the house of your reputation and the things that you're doing, but we see you do these things publicly. That 10th house is incredibly busy in this first half of the month because we've got so many planets moving into the energy of Sagittarius, who lives in that 10th house for you in the general. So starting off on the first, we've got Mercury moving into Sagittarius. So it's going to bring a busyness to work. You're talking, you're having a lot of conversations, things like that. Now, I do want to remind you as well that in the general, Mercury is a ruler of your 7th house. So we call it your love planet. So your love planet is hanging out in the adventurous energy of Sagittarius in your 10th house. This could literally be you're falling in love with your work, or you're falling in love with work-related travel that you're doing, or maybe you're falling in love with someone who's foreign or different than your normal space that you're used to being in, or the normal people you're around. Because on the 13th, Mercury is going to go out of bounds in your career area. So this also means that career opportunities, career advancement, career whatever, and your opportunities to adjust your reputation, maybe even mix and mingle with people who have a little prestige, who have a little status and can change your career direction, you're gonna find them in the out of bounds places. Don't look in your normal spheres. Get out of your comfort zone and go see what else is out there, because Mercury's looking to have these conversations and generate these career ideas as well, or reputation, or what you're doing energies as well. Now on the 14th, we're going to have a new moon solar eclipse happening in Sagittarius, so also in this 10th house area. So this gives us a 6-month commitment to this 10th house area for you. What you manifest here, for good or for ill, you're going to play with that energy for the next 6 months. So I would ask you, what do you want here? What are your seeds of intention that you'd like to plant around your career connections, around your reputation, around who we know you as and see you as in public? Because this will be the energy to take it quite tolerantly, quite open-mindedly, quite adventurously with the energy of Sagittarius. Challenge a truth that you maybe thought about your career area and let this thing expand. It'll be absolutely beautiful. On the 15th, a little bit of a busy day. We've got Chiron, who's an asteroid for us, coming out of retrograde in the energy of Aries. Now, this will light up your second house space, your money, your value, your resources, passive income, your self-esteem, all of that lives over here. And as Chiron has been in the energy of Aries, but certainly retrograde, we've been dealing with the wound or the the hole in the soul that has to do with our identity, has to do with our form, has to do with your money, right? You've been going over the identity of this area. So I would ask you, as Chiron is out of retrograde Pisces, what are the principles that you have that guide how you interact with your money? What is your identity around your money, around your passive income, around your self-esteem, around the things that you value in your possessions? Because Chiron, having done this work and having to get in there and answer some of these questions, now you're also in a position to be able to help someone else answer those questions and not be quite so fearful in this area. It's literally like from your own ache and your own struggle, you're able to give life to someone else by helping them realize they're not alone. I love that. Now, also on the 15th, we've got Venus moving into the energy of Sagittarius as well. So you can see why I say the 10th house is quite busy for you as we're in this first half of the month, and Venus is magnetizing this area, bringing even some harmony. Sometimes Venus does bring a promotion, but it's also Venus, and she's up there with Mercury, your love planet. So this could be bringing in a workplace romance. I'll just tell you, be very, very careful with that at this particular time. If it's going to be able to span the test of time, it will last outside of December, but just be mindful because it can be a little flirtatious here in Sagittarius. Sagittarius actually likes a lot of freedom, so it could be really quick and you fall in love really quick with an office romance or something related to work, and then just as quickly you're out of it. So just be mindful, but there's also something to be said for having the experiences you need to have, right? Okay, that's it. I'm off the soapbox. All right, on the 17th, this is where things start to get, I think, really significant in the shift of our month. Saturn is going to move into the energy of Aquarius and be here for the next 2 years. Now, Saturn has been in the energy of Capricorn, so over in your 11th house space, getting things really social. You had to get serious about your social groupings. You had to get serious about the social places we see you out in public, technology, your long-range plans and goals. I have no doubt that some friends just completely fell out. I have absolutely no doubt about that. But this is also an area, Pisces, where in the 11th house, you would have wanted to be known, like you wanted your accolades, you want to be known as the expert on or whatever. And Saturn has worked on that for the last couple years. So you're very refined in that area. So now it's time to move on. In the energy of Aquarius, this is where we know for the next 2 years, this is about working on that spiritual space. It's about working on things that are behind the scenes, cleaning out that closet, getting those skeletons out of there. It's about treating mental or physical illnesses that you have that we can't innately see, but they are definitely there. It's taking care of that immune system, the autoimmune diseases that maybe pop up. It's taking care of people in your life or being of service to people who are maybe institutionalized in some way, shape, or form. You know, maybe they're in that nursing home or something like that. So this will definitely be a year where your service energy and your refining gets to be in a very quiet space. You are literally refining your spirituality with new thoughts, new information, new ways to connect under the energy of Aquarius. Now, I ask you, Pisces, look back between March and July. Besides the pandemic, what happened and what shifted for you? Were you starting to find spirituality online? Were you connecting to a social group where you were finding, you were like finally coming out, feeling supported, feeling part of the tribe? What happened for you in that time frame? Because that was your sneak peek of what you'll work on for this next 2 years under this Saturn and Aquarius energy, okay? On the 19th, we see Jupiter now coming into the energy of Aquarius as well. Jupiter as one of your ruling planets, certainly in traditional astrology. Jupiter here in Aquarius is much more comfortable. He's got like greater arms. He's like, I can stretch out over here. It's good stuff, right? So Jupiter is ready to expand, which means that your energy will want to expand in this way as well. And I love it in the energy of Aquarius, because it really does say, if you want a different spiritual experience, you'll find it in the area of things that are social, right? Like literally people and engagement of those people and those ideas is literally going to be something that brings you home to that spiritual space to do a bit of growing. So I love that. But Jupiter also brings in spiritual teachers, teachers who help you grow, who help you with a spiritual practice or teach you something very creative, maybe even behind the scenes. Oh, okay. For some of you, you're going to lose a spiritual teacher because something has gone on. There's something that's gone on with a spiritual teacher. It's probably going to come out in this next 6 months. And you're like, no, thank you. I don't want that. Or a teacher. It doesn't even have to be a spiritual teacher. This will be a teacher. And you're like, no, thank you. I'm not interested in that anymore. So whoever that is, please let me know in the comment section down below. Now on the 20th, We've got the Mercury moving into the energy of Capricorn, but on the 21st, which is a very busy day as well, we've got the Sun moving into the energy of Capricorn. So now we've both got Sun and Mercury in the energy of Capricorn, lighting up your 11th house space. You have crystallized this area. You have done a lot of refinement and a lot of growing and mastery in this area. So now as the Sun and Mercury are coming through here, they're just doing like a full sweep. They're like, yeah, let's take this show on the road, right? Do we have friends? Do we have a tribe? Do we have a social grouping? Do we have technology that allows us to be productive? Do we have a long-range plan that when we are traveling through the rest of, you know, this next 4 weeks and we kind of feel off track, we can go, no, it's okay. It's just a bump in the road on the way to my long-range plan. Do you have conversation, vitality, motivation to be with people who socially are helping you achieve? Are your conversations being productive? I also think that this too speaks to that energy I was talking about at the beginning of the month, where maybe you begin to mix and meet with people who have a little prestige, or like the next set of growth that you do really comes from a social place, especially in this next 4 weeks. So pay attention and get into that. The Sun in Capricorn also tells us that we're here at a solstice. We're ready to begin a new season. So if you're in the United States, we're moving into winter. It's time to bring things to rest. It's time to bring them to a slowdown for sure. And if you are having a summer solstice, you're waking it up and getting ready to do things, right? But either way, whatever solstice you're having, this is a time of change, of season change. So embrace it, because it is certainly time to change directions. Now, also on the 21st, we've got that Jupiter-Saturn conjunction, your ruling planet coming in here, mixing and mingling nice and tight with Saturn. Everybody's in Aquarius, lighting up this 12th house space for you. So literally the grand mutation is happening out in the social world. But for you, this is a grand mutation in your spiritual life, in that 12th house space. Ideas, attitudes, behaviors that have kept you from progressing or keep you down, you know, in places of a spiritual experience. Is there something that's happening that's keeping you from having it? Because the energies were very heavy before, very earth. And now we get to move to some of these concepts of the wind and the mind and wearing the world like a loose garment. And you get the opportunity to mutate and to change and to have this great conjunction that combines the wisdom of the ancient with the wisdom of new structures and new teachers to show you how to travel. So I think that's really beautiful here in December. Now, I also think too, on this day, if things do need to come out of hiding in your 12th house, this could be a time where we're gonna see some of that stuff come out of the closet for sure. Now, as we close out this month, we're going to have a full moon in the energy of Cancer, which lights up your fifth house space. The full moon says that something needs to be ended, acknowledged, or adjusted. So in this switch, in this change of energy that we will experience, because it's Cancer, I think of home. Joy at home. Do you have joy in your home? Do you feel nurtured within your family structure? Do you feel nurtured within your own body and your own home? Do you have an expression of joy happening here? So I think that's something that you'll definitely be taken to task to see if you're being nurtured and nourished. Is your spirit, is your home, is your body nourished, right? But also in the fifth house, this is children. This is self-expression. This is taking a risk on things. So those things will definitely be lit up and be put under question under the energy of Cancer. And because this is a cardinal moon, Cancer is a cardinal sign, I think you'll also be taken to task to actually move in this area, do something, start something, begin something in this particular area for you. So there's a very long distance between the head and the heart. So if you can make that connection and let it come out in this fifth house area, or your children are letting things come out for you, like they're having their own expression, and it might be very, very big. It could even be an expression of I miss home from you or from your children or from family members. Whatever it is, that expression has power in owning it, in saying out loud for sure. All right, Pisces, it's been an absolutely brilliant year. We have been through a lot. It has been persistent and rigorous, and here we are at the end of 2020 together. Nonetheless, I look forward to seeing you in 2021. So like this video, comment, share, subscribe. I love you, and I'll see you soon, my fish. Okay? Bye.